In the latest version of Kasm Workspaces 1.16, we released a Helm chat as a technical preview for installing and operating the Kasm Workspaces control plane service as pods in a Kubernetes cluster. Please note that the technical preview is only for testing the feature and is not intended for production at this time. Feedback or issues about this new feature can be submitted on our GitHub issues page. Let me first give you an overview of the environment that I'm using in this video. I'm currently running an RKE2 cluster that is being managed by Rancher. I have three nodes in my cluster. On my host machine, I have kubectl pre-configured for this deployment. I also have Helm installed. Helm is a platform to help you define, install, and upgrade Kubernetes applications. For my three nodes, I have also set up a DNS record and also generated certs with Let's Encrypt. This is optional. The reason I'm doing this is because I want to be able to leverage the RDP HTTPS Gateway, and that would require trusted certs. All right, let's start with the setup. The first thing to do is to clone the Kasm Helm GitHub repo and make sure you're in the right branch. Let's now open this project in VS Code. Values.yaml is where most of your configurations can be defined. There's only a handful of things that you need to manually configure here. The first thing is the namespace. I'll set it to Kasm Test 1. Next up is hostname. The value defined here should resolve to one or more of your nodes in your cluster. In my case, I have a DNS record that points to all three of my nodes. But if you don't have a DNS record in the public zone, or don't intend to use one for testing or lab purposes, you can use services like nip.io to map an IP address to a hostname. For example, if I run a dig command using my node's IP address appended with .nip.io, you'll see that it resolves back to the correct IP address. This allows you to simulate DNS behavior without the need for DNS setups. However, in this demo, I will use the DNS record that I already set up. Next, we have the cluster domain option. Since the agent VMs and server VMs in this deployment will run outside the cluster, we can ignore this step. However, if you're running kubevert or harvester and want all the communication to remain within the cluster's networking, you should configure the cluster domain value and adjust the upstream auth address of the zone after installation. Check the README for detailed instructions if you're working in such an environment. The last thing to configure is the certificates that are associated with the hostname. As already mentioned, I used Let's Encrypt to generate trusted certs for my DNS record to be able to use the RDP HTTPS gateway. So I'll be using these trusted certs in this setup. Make sure to also clean up the new lines and fix the indentation. This step is optional because Kasm generates self-signed certificates by default. So if you don't have or don't need trusted certs, you can proceed without additional configuration. Now that we have configured everything that is required, I'll save the file and execute this Helm command from the GitHub repo. The namespace needs to match with the value that's configured in the values.yaml file. You also need to give it a release name. I'll set it as 1.16.0 and run the command. Now that the Helm chat is deployed, the first thing to do is capture the auto-generated Kasm admin password. You can copy and execute the corresponding kubectl command, which prints out the randomly generated password. Save it somewhere safe for later use. Now let's monitor our deployment. We need to wait until all the services are ready, and this might take several minutes. It starts with the database initialization, and then the other services start coming online because they depend on the database. Now that all of the pods are in running state, we can log into the deployment. You can see that we have some managers, a zone, and some connection proxies defined automatically. Now that we have Kasm core services installed, we can go ahead and deploy a Kasm agent. The Kasm agent can be deployed on bare metal or in a virtual machine, but it cannot be deployed as a pod. In this video, I'll install the Kasm agent on a vanilla Ubuntu server. The instructions for installing a standalone agent in a multi-server deployment can be found in our documentation. The enterprise version of Kasm also offers automated deployment of Docker agents or standalone servers via our auto-scaling plugins, which are available for various cloud providers like AWS, OCI, Google Cloud, Azure, DigitalOcean, and also Kubernetes environments like Harvester and KubeVirt. However, for this demonstration, we will proceed with a manual deployment. In the installation command, I need to plug in some values specific to my deployment. For the public hostname, I will pass my Ubuntu server's hostname. Note that this isn't the public-facing IP or hostname of your machine, but just the IP or name that is resolvable and reachable by the Kasm app running in the Kubernetes cluster. For the manager hostname, I will set the DNS record that I previously configured. Finally, I need to set the manager token. This is an auto-generated value that is created during the installation. To find this, go to your Kasm admin interface, settings, global, scroll down, and in the manager section, you will find the token value. Copy and paste this value to your command. Now that the command is ready, I will run it to install the agent. This process might take several minutes to complete. Once the installation is complete, we should see the agent listed in the Kasm admin interface. Go ahead and enable it. Now that the agent is installed and enabled, let's define a workspace. For this demonstration, let me install Alpine. This will download the image and set it up on Kasm. I will now wait until the image becomes available. Now that the image is ready, we can launch a session. And we are in. This confirms that the agent has been successfully installed and the container-based sessions are now fully operational with Kasm. I also want to verify that I can connect to pre-existing machines over RDP via the new RDP HTTPS Gateway feature in Kasm. To do that, I'll need to define a server in Kasm. I have a pre-existing standalone Windows server that I'll configure here. I'll give it a friendly name, set the deployment zone, set the connection type to RDP, limit maximum simultaneous sessions to 1, input the appropriate IP and port of my server. Finally, I'll give the credentials to log into my server and click Save. Now to create a workspace for this server, I'll go to Workspaces and then click Add Workspace. Set the workspace type to Server. Give it a friendly name and description and select the server that we just created. For the RDP client options, you can select User Selectable, which allows the user to choose whether they want to launch the workspace in a web-native client or an RDP local client. Finally, click Save, and this will create the workspace. Let's go ahead and launch it with the web-native client first. As you can see, this launches the session in the browser. I'll now go ahead and delete this session. Let me now try launching the same workspace using the RDP client, which leverages the RDP HTTPS gateway. When I click Launch Session, the system will generate an RDP file. I can then open this file to establish the RDP connection to the server. While it is possible to configure your browser to automatically launch the RDP file, this is in the default setting. And as you can see, we are now connected to the server in an RDP window. To delete this session, you can close the RDP window and then delete the session in Kasm. And that will be all for this video. In this video, we've walked through the process of setting up Kasm Workspaces 1.16 in a Kubernetes cluster using the new Helm chart, deploying a Kasm agent, and configuring workspaces for containerized and RDP-based sessions. We've also explored how easy it is to manage sessions using both the web-native client and the RDP HTTPS gateway. Remember, this Helm chart is currently a technical preview. So if you encounter any issues or have any feedback, feel free to share them on our GitHub issues page. Thanks for watching, and feel free to check out our documentation for more details. If you enjoyed watching this, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.